Naintindihan nyo na lahat. Diba? Naintindihan nyo na lahat kung bakit anong nangyari. Kasi yung iba, biniblame nila si Duterte. At least ngayon, pinakita na talaga. Okay. Ito ha, maipapanood akong video sa inyo para maklaro talaga kung ano ang ibig sabihin ni Roque. Kasi ang iba, binanatan si Pangulong Duterte. Sige, manood tayo. Para panahon ito ha, sa panahon pa itong COVID. Nasaan ba yun? Hindi ito. Yung isang video. Ito. Manood tayo. We survive because of how Duterte. Ito. Tingnan nyo ha.
But in the Senate hearing, the procurement of the alleged overpriced face masks and shields, including the transfer of $42 billion from DOH to PSDBM, was brought up. Kasali ito sa investigasyon. According to PSDBM, these items were procured last March to April 2020 at the height of the COVID-19 outbreak when the prices of the medical supplies, including face mask and face shield, skyrocketed due to the scarcity of the supply and the abrupt increase in demand. As for the transfer of funds without memorandum of agreement, FOA, face masks and shields are included in the common use supplies and equipment and the list of the PSDBM. Under the Administrative Order Number 7, Series of 2011, in relation to Section 53ERA Number 9184 of the Procurement Reform Act, government agencies are required to procure CSEs directly from PSDBM.
Oh.
Moreover, under Government Procurement Policy Board Resolution Number 2019, dated October of 2018, government agencies are required to deposit cash funds with the PSDBM for the CE requirement. Without the need of a MOA. Now, let me just, I think I remember, nag-ano tayo, cabinet meeting tayo, pagka, noon, right after I constituted the task force. I remember distinctly, sinabi ko kay Secretary Duque, bumili ka ng kailangan ng face mask or whatever is needed, equipment. Sabi ko, huwag ka nang mag-bidding, matagal yan. Sabi ko, do it upon, sabi mo, make it to record na utos ko.
Mm.
But despite of the order ko na huwag ka nang mag-bidding, it's pandemic.
Oh.
It's an emergency.
There you go.
Nevertheless, I, well, knew later on that nagpinadumaan pa rin sa bidding si Secretary Duque. So,
oh,
he was just being careful. Alam mo, sa totoo lang, nung pagputok nitong pandemic, walang mga face mask, walang face shields.
Totoo!
Kaya sabi ko, maghanap ka, huwag ka na magpabidding. Sabi ko, diretso na kasi in an emergency. So, at that time, it's always the law of supply and demand.
Totoo.
Kung maraming supply, mura. Kung walang supply, less demand. Supply and demand. Is there a demand? Pag greater, supply. Ganito, so sabi ko sa kanya, huwag ka nang pabiding-biding, diretso na. So I want to make it a record to the public and everybody that I and the cabinet knew about it. My order, sabi ko,
whoa,
go ahead and buy the things that you need to fight the pandemic nga eh. So sabi ko, emergency ito. Emergency hanggang ngayon. So just to disabuse the minds of some people about corruption.
There you go.
It ain't here at this time. And I suppose that you are barking at the wrong person.
Duh.
And the next that we would be interested to hear is Secretary Ramon Lopez of the DTI. He might want to help us explain the pricing of the mask and the officials at the time. At another time it became more expensive. Then why it became cheaper, and eventually cheapest. Why was the parang ikaw yung alam mo yung mga presyo na yon at that time? So can you kindly explain to the public why that was the case?
Okay, thank you po, Mr. President. Good evening sa lahat, Senator Bongo, Mr. President, at sa ating mga kasama. Naalala po natin nung nag-uumpisa na pong lumala ang pandemya nung March of 2020. Prior to that, we started to get more COVID cases. Pero nung March 2020 po, the president will recall that yun po yung series of cabinet meetings and the time that you also declared a lockdown. I think it was sometime March 15 of 2020 last year. Being in lockdown, isa po sa mga eventually nire-require ng government at that time was pag-umpisa na nung pagsuot ng face mask. So eventually po, this has been required to the public. So we can imagine na from practically zero demand, wala namang gumagamit ng face mask nung araw, to something like millions of users of face mask. Nung mga panahon po na yan, ng March of 2020 onwards, until now po. No? But given the huge increase in the demand, we all remember that yung demand na to, and imagine po, wala pong local manufacturer niyan. Meron po isang local manufacturer sa Bataan, but it is an exporter, and all its products practically were exported. So we don't have a regular supply of face masks. If at all drugstores are just maintaining minimum inventory of face masks because it's not a regular requirement. So with the limited supply, as the president also explained earlier, and super increase, and drastic increase in demand, nagkaroon po talaga ng scarcity at yung presyo po talaga nagtaasan. It was really uncontrollable because of the scarcity. Even us in the Department of Trade and Industry, and I know the Department of Health, the Department of Budget Management, we're trying to source also from imports at that time, I remember, because wala po tayong local supply. And even other countries are not even supplying us.
True.
Wala na ring makuha even from imports during those time of March, April, because they also needed the mask. Lumalala rin yung COVID dun sa mga iba-ibang countries na yon. So there was really a huge shortage ng mask. At nag-canvas po tayo sa iba't ibang bansa at that time. So, at dahil po doon, ay sumobrang taas ng mask to the point na I remember may papakita ako mga charts na during the time of mga March and April, the price of mask, imagine po, yung dati pong siguro wala pang 5 piso, ay naging around 28 or more, about 30 pesos per piece, per piece of a mask. No? So, may I request the secretariat to flash the chart? Abang fina-flash po yan, even nung nag-try po tayong mag-introduce at mag-umpisa ng local manufacturing, nagkaubusan din itong tela mismo, trying to source the material. Because of the huge demand worldwide, may scarcity value rin, nagtaasan din ang presyo mismo ng materials. So kung locally magagawa na natin, mataas ang presyo, kung bibilin din abroad, mataas na rin ang presyo because it was really a big demand po worldwide. Just to show po some slides, just to help us recall even the prices at that time. And I remember the DOH together with the DTI, nagtulong po kami na mag-set ng SRP, suggested retail price, at para ho ma-monitor natin yung presyo po nito because para ma-control natin yung pagtaas ng presyo even sa market. And we distinctly remember and we reviewed the documents, mga news reports, if we can flash po the secretariat can flash the charts, it showed po that at around March, we declared in an SRP of 28 pesos per piece because the prices then were really going up even beyond 28 pesos. So at that point, 28 pesos was parang a suggested retail price or in effect a price cap at that time. So Secretariat, I hope you can flash the chart para lang mapakita natin yung the memo at in those dates. And also some newspaper reports that reported na itong mga presyo na to were happening during those days towards March and April na covered by different news media. Nevertheless, anyway, kung wala pa yung slides, after that po, at that point in time, hindi pa required din yung face shield. So wala pa sa picture yung face shield. But eventually, with the advice from health experts that are helping and advising the IATF, eventually, ni-require na rin ang face shield. Ginawa pong siyang requirement. Ang una pong nag-require po noon, the other set of slides po, Secretariat, hindi yan. Ang una pong nag-require nung face shield sa transportation. There was a memorandum from the Department of Transportation, I remember, at nasa slides po natin yun, dineclare po niyang required na ng mga tao, aside from face mask, to wear face shield para double protection. And the protection can, kung ang face mask ay about 80% protection, with the face shield magiging 98% protection. Dali, maliit yung slides. So ito po, I think this was an article going back to the face mask. It was a Sunstar article in Cebu at about that date. Maliit lang yung chart dito, hindi ko makita, March, certain day in March, na ang presyo po ay sinasabi dito 28 pesos. So maganda rin na nabalita yan. It shows us that during those date, yan talaga ang presyuhan noon. Yan niligyan ng SRP. The earlier chart would show a memo also from the issued by the Department of Health Secretary, Secretary Duque, na we set the SRP at that time at 28 pesos. Ito po yung memo na yon. Okay, followed by the news article in Sunstar and another article in I think this is an ABS-CBN, TV Patrol type of article, setting again, reporting that the SRP at that time, March, middle of March, was 28 pesos. Next chart. Okay, and then ito na po, pumasok na po yung requirement, the need for face shield. This is sometime August, Mr. President. This was sometime August, and we set the price of the face shield. I will just open my chart po dito dahil maliit yung chart dyan. So yung face shield po, DOH memorandum din po, this was August 14. And down below, pinabilog po natin, sinet po yung price ng face shield, 26 pesos to 50 pesos. But the following charts will show us, nagpa-price monitoring tayo at that time. Again, same reason po. From a zero demand to suddenly it is being required by almost the entire populace. Let's go to the last chart. the price monitoring that we were doing, you will see in the chart, on the last chart, that the price of price range of face shield, yung iframe, yung ganito po, no? Yung may iframe, nagre-range po at that time, 50 pesos to 120 pesos. Yung merong foam, 30 pesos to 80 pesos, at yung helmet type ay 250 pesos to 350 pesos per piece. And then that's the reason why we had to set an SRP at that time in August, as mentioned po, that was required and set at 26 pesos to 50 pesos. Again, it's a memorandum signed by DOH. Dahil po DOH ang covered po ng DOH itong mga medical devices, and DTI helps them in the monitoring and ensuring that the retail establishment would follow the suggested retail price. But as we all know po, after that, Mr. President, nag-normalize na ang supply. Mm. Nakahabol na ang sama na yung importation. We were also able to develop local manufacturers of face masks, even a face shield. And that's the reason why we have already abundant supply of face masks until now, Mr. President. So the prices now are really very very low. You would say that it's less than even, I think, less than 5 pesos, anywhere between 2 pesos to 5 pesos. But these are the prices now. After nag-adjust na po yung market, yung supplier, and the same demand continues kasi it continues to be required, but at least po yung supply po natin nakahabol na. So yun po yung history na there were really days and months last year na nag-worsen talaga itong presyo. And it happens worldwide po, Mr. President. Nagkaroon po talaga ng worldwide shortage. That's all, Mr. President.
Tere Lopez, thank you for the education of everybody, for the enlightenment. I would like to call si Ms. Tina Rose Marie Kanda, DBM.
Yes, sir, Mr. President.
Magkamali ba dito ang DOH? Is there any mistake or is there any whatever damage to prejudice to a government interest?
No, Mr. President.
Yes, ma'am. Go ahead.
There is no mistake on the part of DOH in terms of the amount they utilize. In fact, the findings of COA was under utilization of their allotment. Pero
go.
As explained earlier po, i-explain ko din further siguro, ang nangyari po, inad yung dalawang bagay na totally unrelated. Yung isa po tinatawag natin na obligation, yung unobligated tsaka undisbursed, magkaiba po yun. Ngayon dun ho sa transfer naman ng pondo, at that point po, pandemic yun, wala na hong pumapasok sa opisina at that time ng ECQ. So I think DOH had no recourse but to transfer the fund to PSDBM at that time.
Oh,
and cool. Under the laws naman, talagang pag common use equipment, talaga pong sa PS yun ipoprocure by law, kailangan doon sa procurement service yun.
Yun lang ho, kung may idagdag ka, if you have some advice to the DOH or to us, we would be happy to hear you. Pagka wala naman, then sabihin mo lang na kung ano pang may idagdag mo, then we can excuse you.
Yes. Mr. President, just two things that was raised by Secretary Duque earlier about yung kung mga vaccinator at saka po yung pondo para sa doon po sa SRA. Doon po sa SRA, pwede po natin i-release yon mula sa Miscellaneous Personal Benefits Fund kasi allowance po yon. Ang pangalawa naman po, yung sa vaccinator, part of that, meron kaming nakitang 1.6 billion sa DOH pertaining to 2020 na ano nila, na hindi nila nagamit, nahandun lang naman po yun. Pwede nilang gamitin po yun. Tapos yung balance po nung na kailangan, kasi 3.6 yata ang kailangan nila, pwede po natin kunin sa contingent fund. In fact, pa-forward na po, papunta na po sa inyo para po sa approval. And siguro po hindi naman aabot ng 10 araw yon para matanggap po ng ating mga health workers yung kailangan na yun. Yun pong allowance ng vaccinator.
Well, it's good that you mentioned about the sourcing of the funds. Yes, it's the contingent fund has always been being looked with suspicion. Yes, not only in Congress, but with everybody. Kasi contingent is parang malawak na parang anong gastusin mo. So these are the things that the public never really knew or know na ito is to meet itong mga crisis na ganito. Good that we have the contingent fund because we responded to the emergency, which is really an emergency pandemic.
Yes, yes.
Na sabi ko nga sana, I'd like to say it again, that my order even to Secretary Duque was to go ahead and buying without bidding. But to his maybe thinking that it would create more problems, binidding niya. So well and good, and nandyan yan. So ito lang para just to clear up, because the people have the right to know where the money is.
Very good.
Yes. So ito na yung sabi ko nga, because if we do not, actually if I did not call you to appear in public, there would always be many, it will linger on the minds of the people that kinukurakot yung pera.
True. Yan.
And at this time, pandemic pa. Tapos malaman nila itong ganito na, I said, conundrum of, mas marunong. Mabuti marinig na nila. So I'm happy that you joined us tonight and you can be excused. Maraming salamat po.
Marami pong salamat, Mr. President.
Sabi nila, istrikta ka daw, ma'am. Acting sa sabi nila, ayaw, mas mabuti. The stricter you are, the better. Mas malayo tayo sa sakit ng ulo, mas malayo tayo sa kaso pag inistrikto tayo. So continue being strict and continue being the protector of the people's interest. Thank you very much.
Marami pong salamat po.
Yun na ha. Nakita nyo na kung paano in-explain ni Pangulong Duterte lahat ng pera. So yun na, kabibig. Dito ko natatapusin ang aking live. Nakita yun ang ebidensya. Nakita yun ang ebidensya. So bye everyone. See you tomorrow. Bye. Salamat sa panonood. Good night everyone.